Mr. Nils Lofgren, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I came to dance. Yes, I came to dance. It's a rhythm romance I'm having with my shoes.
As all of his diehard fans already know, he's been rocking the world stage for over four decades. While he may be best known for his role as guitar player and sideman, Nils Lofgren has also made a name for himself as a solo artist and songwriter. Nils grew up in Virginia, just outside of Washington, D.C., where his parents encouraged his love of music.
My parents danced all the time. So they loved music, they played it in the house all the time, and when I asked for lessons, they were aware of the healing properties of music and encouraged all my brothers, all my three other brothers, play music really well and sing. And so I asked my parents for accordion lessons, and they said, sure. I started entering contests where you compete. And the first time I entered, I placed second, and then the last competition, I went back and took first place.
As a young teenager, Nils picked up the guitar. And at the age of 16, he had a life-changing experience when he first saw Jimi Hendrix in concert.
I was following everyone around the East Coast to see these inspired shows. I remember, I think I was 16, I saw Jimi Hendrix on his first tour in Washington, D.C. He played the Ambassador Theater, which was an imitation Fillmore Ballroom. We'd all already been to Constitution Hall in D.C. to see the Blues Magoos, Herman's Hermits, and The Who. And it was the original Who. And then we all ran over to see Jimi Hendrix, and Pete Townsend did too. He was in the audience. Jimmy dedicated a song to him. And I remember that night watching Jimmy feeling with possessed with the notion to try being a professional rock musician. And that possession, if you will, carried on into, you know, through the summer into my senior year of high school. And
I dropped out of high school. It bored me to death.
About a month into my senior year, I left school, put a note under my pillow to my parents. I ran away to Greenwich Village. And went to record companies and walked in and asked for a job. And a lot of people just said, why should we give you a job? And I'm like, and I realized, because I love music so much. I crawled back home and I put my band Grin together quickly. And we became an original band and we became a big local band.
Nils would often sneak backstage at concerts in nearby clubs to meet the bands. The next life-changing experience came when he slipped backstage at the cellar door to meet Neil Young and Crazy Horse.
I snuck in on Neil Young and Crazy Horse, who had just put out Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere. I loved Neil from his Buffalo Springfield work, and I was a fan of his. I walked in and asked for advice, and Crazy Horse, like, go to New York, kid. They were kind of annoyed that the 16-year-old walked in on, or 17, I think I was. And Neil said, well, do you have any songs with your band? I said, yeah, I write songs, and we've got a handful of songs. And he handed me his Martin that he was practicing on, play me a song. So I played him like Rain or Outlaw from the first Grin record.
Saw you last morning, cried my sins out.
And Neil was like, you know, those are really good songs. You really are good, man. You know what? Why don't you hang out with us for a couple of days? And all of a sudden, he said, look, when you get to L.A., look me up. I'll be happy to help you out.
So, after striking out in New York, the band decided to go west. Young's producer, David Briggs, took Grin under his wing, landing them a recording contract and producing four albums. At the age of 18, Nils was invited by David and Neil to play guitar and piano on the After the Gold Rush album.
Neil and David said, we're doing this project After the Gold Rush. We want you to play guitar, sing, and some piano. And at that point, I was like, well, you guys, I knew them for a year, so they were kind of like big brothers, but I wasn't that intimidated because I was around them all the time. So, well, you know, I'm not a professional piano player. And that's when David and Neil, who knew my history, pointed out to me, well, you've been playing accordion since you were five. Yeah, and you've won contests, classical. I said, yeah. So we need some simple piano parts, and we think you can handle it. So at that point, since I already told him I wasn't a professional piano player, I realized I should shut up and say thank you, and I did. and we made the After the Gold Rush album. And this particular day, Ralphie Molina, the drummer, stayed behind, and he was jamming with me. And we were working on Southern Man, which was a halftime beat. It was like boom, boom, whack, it just all happened. We do that for about a half an hour. Then I thought, well, let me change it up. And remember, I came from the accordion waltz polka thing. So, the, you know, roll out the barrel. That mm-pa, mm-pa. So that was so ingrained in me that what I did was get rid of the chord. I just started doing the octave. And Ralphie started double timing the backbeat. So we had a faster beat, and we go. So when they came back from lunch, we were in this roaring groove with that feel, and Ralphie was double timing the song, and Neil and David said, "What the hell's that?" And I said, "Well, that's Southern Man with a polka beat." And they laughed and said, "Man, that feels great." So it was kind of neat that, especially back then in the 60s, the accordion kind of got a square rap. So it was kind of neat that my accordion days led to a cool arrangement change on a special record like that. And that's a good After the Gold Rush tune end story.
In 1974, after Grin, Nils went on touring and recording as a solo artist.
My band Grin made 4 albums, got a lot of critical acclaim, and the showbiz story is you're not making money for the company, eventually you lose your deal, which happened to us. We did a farewell concert. We were the first rock band allowed to play at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C. I was a little down because in the early 80s, after making good albums that got critical acclaim and doing good shows live, I was being called a dinosaur. So it was kind of a startling thing in the early 80s. And I called Bruce, and he could tell I was a little down. I said, "Why don't you come up and hang for the weekend?" And we did.
In the twists and turns that life can bring, Nils never could have imagined what would happen next.
Fast forward to 84, I got a call from Bruce and went in and played a couple of days with the band and wound up being the replacement guitarist. This is just all a month before the Born in the USA tour.
While on break from Springsteen in 1989, Nils joined Ringo Starr's first 2 all-star bands.
And the Born in the USA tour is when I met Ringo at his home and led to playing in his 89 and 92 Ringo Starr and the all-star band.
Now please welcome Nils Lofgren.
Dreams come true and musical gifts to be in a band like that. And now to be in a band with one of the Beatles was the whole reason I left classical accordion and picked up the guitar.
Nils met his wife, Amy, in 1980 at the Stone Pony in Asbury Park while on an East Coast tour. They lost touch and then after 15 years were reunited in Scottsdale, Arizona. They've been together ever since, and Nils has made Scottsdale his home.
21 years here in Arizona, and my 4 dogs, my son Dylan's down in Tempe. I got a lot of friends locally, you know, Danny Zalesko, Otto, all these great engineers and people I met, and live musicians that have worked with me. So now it's just kind of chipping away and keeping the creativity alive, which for me, the next big project is writing an album. So anyway, I've had a very beautiful history journey. Yeah, there's been a lot of ups and downs. There's been, you know, from like the early days of striking out and not being able to get a job in New York and saying, "Hey, you're not good enough yet," and going out to LA and getting lucky with help from Neil and David Briggs. And then in the early 80s, all the record deals dry up and people say, "You're a dinosaur. Love you, you're great, but there's no work here for you." And then, you know, all of a sudden I'm in Bruce's band. And all of a sudden there was a record deal.
So don't let nothing stop you from dreaming. Don't let nobody keep you from your dream now.
Always the dreamer, Nils has shown in his long career that success comes with persistence and hard work. He never gave up on his dreams.
Sure, you see Jimi Hendrix or Jeff Beck play and you know, like, I should just quit. But fortunately, thank God, look, if I was just a guitar player, I would quit. But fortunately, I'm a songwriter. So, you know, then you look at Lennon, McCartney, and Dylan, and you go, I should quit writing songs. But I'm not just a songwriter. And then as a singer, you look at Paul Rogers and Muddy Waters and, you know, Aretha Franklin and Sam Cooke, and like, well, I should quit singing. But thankfully, I do all this stuff. So in a big batch mixed together, people show up, and I'm like, well, I want them to show up again, so let me do my best.
Hi, Nils. Congratulations on your induction to the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame. Trio here, we think you're a fantastic ambassador for Arizona, for our state, also for our country, and we congratulate you and wish you the best.
Congratulations, Nils. We'll see you New Year's Eve.
Nils, it's well-deserved, well-deserved. Your music is great.
Keep on rocking. Rockin'.
I'm gonna try it again, but
yeah.
Keep on rocking.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Oh, yeah.
Keep on rockin'.
It was a cue, right?
Ready?
Yeah.
Keep on rockin'.
I first met Nils in the studio with Dick Wagner. Dick, we were producing an album that was mostly rock and roll, but one of the songs was called Pirate Love, and Dick said, we need an accordion. So he called in Nils Lofgren. I had no idea that Nils played accordion. Nils just ripped through accordion through the whole song and played his butt off and added this new joy to the album. Congrats, Nils, you rock.
Nils, I'm thrilled that you're being inducted to the Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame. Congratulations.
Hi, Nils. I want to congratulate you on your induction into the Arizona Entertainment Hall of Fame. As you can see, I'm wearing my 1991 Nils Lofgren tour jacket, one of my most prized possessions and one I've not taken off since 1991 when you found it for me on the tour bus.
Hey, big brother, congratulations on this well-deserved honor. We were fortunate to have supportive parents that encouraged us to make a living doing what we loved, musician and builder. I have the bonus of acquiring musical talent and drive through osmosis and the honor of performing in venues far beyond my own reach with you. You're my favorite guitar player. Love you, brother.
I want to congratulate you on your nomination for the award, and we're very proud of you, and you have worked very hard to get where you are.
And Nils, you're such a great musician, but even better than that, you're a great brother. We love you, we miss you, can't wait to see you soon. Congratulations on this great accomplishment.
The Arizona Music and Entertainment Hall of Fame is honored to induct Nils Lofgren.